This building has some simple underground structures only. We'll use the already created exterior walls to place the necessary foundations. Open the foundation floor plan view from the pop-up navigator. The existing walls can be seen with dashed outlines according to their floor plan and section settings. Turn on Trace and Reference on the standard toolbar to see the skins of wall composites, especially the load-bearing core structure. The existing walls are visible because their bottom plane is below the top of the current story. Activate the Wall tool. Open its Settings dialog and display the Geometry and Positioning panel. Set Wall Top to Ground Floor. Enter minus 0.10 for top offset to top linked story. Enter 0.00 for bottom offset to current story so that the foundation height will be 0.9 meters. Set foundation for home story. Select the basic structure. And select reinforced concrete structural for the building material. Enter 0.60 for thickness. Set the reference line to inside face. Enter 0.05 for reference line offset. Display the categories and properties panel. Select load-bearing element for structural function, exterior for position, and wall for element classification. Make sure that the structural bearing layer is selected. Click OK to close the dialog. Draw the wall segments so the reference line of the foundation meets the reference line of the walls above. You can turn on the View, On-screen View options, Walls and Beams Reference Lines option to better see the reference line of the placed walls. Use the Chained Geometry method for faster placement. Follow the reference line direction of the existing walls when placing the foundations. Space-click the curved stone wall to place the foundations. The thickness of the foundation under the stone wall is not wide enough. Select this foundation segment. Open the Wall Selection Settings dialog and change its thickness to 0.80. When finished, stretch this foundation in both directions using angular stretch. Select the curved foundation and click its end node. Select the angular stretch option from the PET palette. Raise the chord value by 0.10 meters in both directions as shown on the screen. Use the Tab key to switch between the input fields of the tracker. Zoom out to check the foundation intersections. We also need foundations under the wooden columns. Activate the Column tool and open its Settings dialog. Display the Geometry and Positioning panel. Set Column Top to Ground Floor. Enter minus 0.17 for top offset to top linked story. Enter 0.00 for bottom offset to current story. Set foundation for home story. Enter 0.50 for both sizes. Select reinforced concrete structural for building material. Display the categories and properties panel. Select load-bearing element for structural function, exterior for position, and column for element classification. Make sure that the structural bearing layer is selected and click OK to close the dialog. Click the midpoints of the wooden columns to place the foundations. Turn off walls and beams reference lines using the View, On-Screen View Options menu. Turn off Trace as well. In this chapter, you set and placed entrance doors, internal doors, windows, and skylights into the building model with different snap options. Then you modified the openings in 3D View. You also added a stair and discovered the wide range of options for both GDL and StairMaker stairs. Finally, you created the foundations to complete the load-bearing structure of the building.